more of attrition.
Can't kill the shuttle because the speed's gone off it, so...
In the end, it drops long from looking to grow. 25-plus shot rally.
I have to give that to Lo Juan Shen for finding the breakthrough.
Get rid of that shuttle. That's going into the dustbin outside. Oh, it's a little graveyard for shuttlecocks.
Lucky.
Space where Lucky was looking at.
Big serve dari lawan.
Panjat in the yellow. More than holding their own against their much battling giant. Back in the lead. Sixth and fourth error from Kaming and Dronchen.
This would be a nick and nick game, and so it has proved.
Five, four. Forced errors, that's 10 to 6. So 10 against Lucky and Mohamed Ishmael. Precious little to choose between the pairings.
Kebanyakan mata daripada kedua pasangan ini melalui pelampuan rendah dan tajam. Jadi siapa yang buat defensif terlalu banyak tu, itulah kemungkinan dapat.
We are now at the midway point of this game. 15 minutes maximum to play.
Asakan agresif.
Two-handed bat-in by Shao Ishmael.
Seven, six.
That's not in any textbook.
Oh, Juan Chuan was keeping Kelly Jaya alive most of that rally, but a loose shot from Chua Kaming, he could do nothing about that one, even though he was on his knees.
Chua Kaming tidak perasan, tidak menyadari yang Shao sudah menunggu di bagian hadapan. Kita lihat bagaimana.
A big swig of water for Lucky Nugroho.
Tangan mereka bila melakukan serangan dan juga.
Thank you. Story of Ampang Jaya season. 2 wins so far. In progress here against BJ. Petaling next game. Kepong Serdang and Puchong United. Top 6 qualifying for stage 2 of this season 2, I believe. And then we have the grand finals.
Setakat ini Ampang Jaya melalui carta liga yang dibarisi oleh kesemuatan
BJ on the defense of the league champions, of course.
Seven, on.
Six over. A really sharp over there from Lucky and Shao Ishmael.
Inch forward.
Pass
serve like that to Elijah Ranshen. A bit high, punished. That's the chance now to serve.
Coming forces the error. Nine. Looking to go home. Now, is that the telling point? Is that the turn on those 2 points? PJ in the lead. Too much on it because he couldn't beat him with raw power.
Desperately trying to find a breakthrough, but in the end he's just giving it to Petlin Jaya. Fantastic chance to close out game three.
Points, 10-8. John Chen on serve.
Game for PJ.
There's loose from looking at global game one man. It's 11-8. 4 points in succession to wrap up the third game.
He leads 2 games to 1.
Akhirnya, you sense that that could be the turning point of the match, those 4 points.
Well, as I said, it's the quiet dominance of the Petlin Jaya players, which I have full admiration of. I mean, you get a lot of fireworks, a lot of rough and tumble, but quite a lot of errors as well. And it's in the smallest of margins, you see there, Turkey punishing a loose serve. Juanchen very careful on the defense so many times. He's overpowered that time, but it's the softest of the shots. He's playing as well.
20 seconds.
I'm quite impressed by this pairing from Petlin Jaya, as I say, they've quietly taken game three. Position going into game four. As we look at the shot chart here, we see the errors, just 3 errors from Ampang Jaya, but mostly winners in that midcourt area from Petlin Jaya. That's the partnership of Chua Kaming and Mo Juan Shen. We will have the serve going into game four.
Fourth game,
lawan Lamor.
Itu di bahagian belakang dan dua play di bahagian hadapan.
One.
A few marital problems.
Chua Kaming looks at him as if to say, sort it out.
Coming. Acres of space to just the shuttle back into.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Tempting the attack from Ampang Jaya. And then so clinical to punish any open space. Straight in the corner from Chua Kaming.
Just the back of your stats, the most number of winners is 18 to Lucky and Shawl, but they've had more errors as well. So 18 winners, 12 errors. They had 16 winners from the racket.
Just 7 unforced errors.
Si
mereka menentang bangsa Hawks Selasa depan pada 26 Mei bulan Disember. Manakala Ampang Jaya juga pada Selasa depan menentang pertandingan ini.
Buries it between the legs of Charles.
Two.
Perfectly placed in the net there from Juan Shen. It forced the lift. This is the lift that Chua Kaming got on the end of.
Three, all.
sekat ini standard ataupun corak permainan kedua kelab ini cukup seimbang sebab dua perlawanan sebelum ini persoalan lelaki dan persoalan wanita berakhir dengan 5 set ya. 3-2, 3-2 dan kemungkinan ya, ya. Dalam bergulir lelaki ini kita kena tunggu sampai game kelima.
4-3.
Is the word clinical, it's the perfect adjective.
Well, it's where Kelly and Jaya are using the
scalpels and
the old battle axe, you know. It's quite a contrast in styles, but John Shen for me again has been one of the standout players. You see his craft on the net there. So valuable for
ini juga merupakan platform terbaik pada para pemain yang aktif dalam BWF ataupun tidak kerana boleh dianggap sebagai match play sebelum bermulanya tahun baru 2018.
We go to a fifth set, it certainly will. Just over 8.25 minutes to play.
Match practice cukup penting bagi para pemain untuk menaikkan prestasi mereka, terutama jika lawan prestasi ataupun level yang lebih baik daripada pemain.
Momentum can change in the blink of an eye. That's out. Three in a row for Pangjaya. Four situation. It's certainly now a leading situation.
All that diving effort for nothing. It's the shot winner.
The Sports Arena Sentosa, venue for the Purple League. All of the matches that PJ have still got to play. They've won one, they were battered by Puchong, they've still got Bangsa next, won by Cheres, Pataling and Ketbong. In many ways, that is an easier finale to the season. And many of their rivals, they would certainly expect to be in the top six, ideally in the top three.
So it's over, six,
so costly when there's absolutely nothing between the sides.
Tidak
at
banyak
all.
Rally panjang setakat ini.
Of course, there is now almost level.
They
are in level 13 apiece now.
So it's over. 7-8.
Just being bamboozled at the net there.
Just waiting for the error.
He's patient. Play from Kelly and Jaya. Didn't try and blow any chances. Just kept on pressing, probing until the error came.
Went four in a row from 7-8 to win game three. I'm not going to win four in a row in game four.
7-8.
On the clock, Tom
Lehmann's
juga kepada pihak lawan, Luki dan juga Shawa.
9-8
kini. It's likely to be a short game.
Oh.
What a big miss that is from Carmen.
String has gone. Putus, tapi itulah Shawa telah pun merebahkan badan. Luki pula terpaksa mengawal
seluruh
pelanggan dan kesilapan dari Karana.
What he might say is because the string went, but in reality it's the errors that came many times before that, which is now caught with the broken string.
10-8 game point untuk game yang keempat ini. Kemungkinan kita akan menyaksikan game kelima berturut-turut dalam tiga perlawanan. Kemungkinan akan berlaku.
Clock is counting down. We are precisely 5 minutes to play.
PJBC 4-2-1 dan game keempat ni nampaknya Luki dan Syawal berjaya mencuri mata-mata penting dalam situasi getir.
And they've taken it by going to 5. Good way through that game 4. Given much chance for Ampang Jaya to pull this one back.
Well, it's exactly what you were saying on the stats. There's the unforced error rate checked up for Peddling Jaya, and then when something unlucky happened in the form of the string breaking, they weren't in the position for him to absorb that loss. And real credit to Luki Negroho there. You see the nerve still kept his head just at the right moment, played a beautiful quick serve.
70 points have been played in the contest so far, 35 each. It really is as close as the two-all scoreline would suggest.
20 seconds.
The team's really got the penetration when they're on the offense.
Good composure from Luki Negroho to serve that one out. As you look at the shot chart, you see the errors, massive amount of errors. All those errors are Peddling Jaya errors in red.
Final game.
And only 3 winners needed for Ampang Jaya to take game 4.
Deciding game 5. Drops in.
One love.
Jadi, big smash didn't work, the little floater did.
Tadi macam memang pukulan tu keluar, tapi itulah disebabkan angin dan sebagainya pergerakan shuttle. Kadang-kadang masuk langgar.
So it's over. One on.
The clock counts down towards the 4-minute mark.
Decision over power with good effect that time.
Three.
Luki seemed to get in the way of Shaul Ismail in trying to give him the space. Number 33 is representing Peddling Jaya. Blinks first. Juan Chen blinks first. 3-3.
The rally that was pure end-to-end stuff. Finally, the points decided in the space of about 1 millimeter of the net. So.
Yeah, sudah pasti dengan mempelbagai
kerana the
pukulan menarik juga, pukulan lambung ke depan, smash dan sebagainya.
So, three all.
Nyata keempat-empat pemain ini bergerak dengan memang efisien dalam gelanggang.
7 maybe 8 points.
Kemungkinan besar kerana mereka sudah pun serasi antara satu sama lain. Luki dan Shawa pernah menjadi juara dalam perjalanan lawan nasional. Sementara bagi Kaming dan Juan Shen juga pernah menjuarai International Challenge.
One of Shurikaraming's best attacks of the match so far. Just when Pedling Jaya needed it as well. No sting on that attack.
Langsung sengit. 54 saat saja lagi.
The clock isn't ticking. But an innovation for this season's Purple League.
Five.
Crucially, it's a two-point lead for PJ.
Change of ends.
Bertukar court. Di sinilah saat-saat paling
change of ends will be quite welcome for Rampage Jaya. Just brings up the momentum there. Pedling Jaya had one of 3 points.
Terutama sekali.
10 seconds.
Jika pihak lawan dari agak jauh, sebenarnya sukar untuk bangkit semula. 6-3 kepada pasangan.
Yes. Coming.
DJ have won the battle of wills in the previous two singles matches, taking the fifth game. Here they're leading 6-3.
Three. Play. Seven.
Oh, it's been called good. A little bit of hittery from Shaul Ismail. Calming forces the error. 5 points in a row. Perfect time to hit this match.
Calming dan juga Juan Shen kini 8-3 meninggalkan Luki dan juga Shawa.
Too many. A longish rally of 8 seconds.
Permainan di bahagian net. Gaya mesti ada, Roslin. Tu nombor satu juga.
Kalah menang
juga betul. Tapi apapun, itu semua pemain memang isu tersendiri. Di bahagian tengah.
Actually, we could get a proper winner. Match point. 6 match points.
Lebih kurang 13 saat lagi.
Buzzer goes, yeah. And the match is won.
Jadi secara keseluruhan berpihak kepada Pedang Jaya.
The shuttle dropped in, so the point goes to Ampang Jaya. The final score is a 10-5 fifth game win and a 3-2 win for Pedang Jaya. That's overall a 9-6.
Final game won by Pedang Jaya BC 10-5. Match won by Pedang Jaya BC 3-2.
Keupayaan Kamen dan juga Yuan Shen di game yang kelima, yaitu game penentuan. Tetapi
well, it was a game really for the badminton purists. Saw a lot of different elements on display here. We saw some contrasting styles between the aggressive, flair and skill-based approach from Ampang Jaya and the rather measured and crafted approach. You see Lord Juan Shen in particular finding the gaps, finding the angles, making life difficult for Ampang Jaya, trying to pull the Ampang Jaya players out of position. In the end, they look looked like they were going to get blown away in the early stages of the match, but that craft and consistency did finally pay off. In particular, Chair coming good at the end. He had a pretty mixed game until the last set, but he saved his best shots for last and helped
counter-attack dan juga
statistics when we look at them will show that there were slightly less errors from the losing team, but there were more winners coming from the racket of the team in red and black. And credit to Lucky and Charles Ismail for taking us to five games. It's a consistent, steady Eddie, conservative approach from PJ that won them this game.
Right, and a lot of positional discipline. You see, there's a good example of how they were able to open up the lack of positional discipline from Ampang Jaya. They kept their heads and they found the gaps, found the angles. And I just really want to say it's a good message to any young badminton player out there that there is a place for skill and craft, and it's not just all about power in men's doubles.
In those men's doubles, let's look at the stats. 31 winners at all, 15 at the front, 16 at the back, compared to 23 unforced errors, just about even, 17 to 14. It was, as you say, a game for the purists, but another important maximum for Petaling Jaya. They now lead 9-6, they've got a maximum 9 out of 9. And coming up next, we've got a mixed doubles maximum. Well, it'll be difficult for them to continue that run because Marcus Kiddo, the former world number one, is up against them. Mixed doubles is coming up next. Can't complain about value for money in the match between Ampang Jaya and Petaling Jaya. Match day three of the Purple League. Maximum number of games here we can possibly have. Have been played 9-6 it is for PJ, who've won 3-2 in each of the matches so far. The men's winning singles, as we've just seen, John Chen coming in the men's doubles. Could be different here though, because Kei Yogendran and Chi Wai Chi
up against formidable opponents from Indonesia.
Pegang Jaya, show your support to Koyo Gendra and Ji Wei Chi.
It's been a really good year for Yugendran. But for Ji Wei Chi, she's just inside the world top 500. And this will very much be a learning experience for her.
And for Ampang Jaya, we have Marcus Kilo and Ririn Amelia.
The girls on the other side run out for Ampang Jaya. Ririn Amelia is just outside the world top 50 in mixed doubles. Whereas Marcus Kilo, former world number one in the doubles, he just loves playing the game. Chunkier than his world number one days, but still
namun,
a consummate player.
Coin toss. And we get the thoughts dalam
Donald Spears.
Ampang Jaya,
cakap tentang
yellow or green?
Gendren, beliau mempunyai pasangan tetap dalam bergu campuran.
Tiu is to serve, receive.
Dan cemerlang dalam beberapa kejuanan bersama dengan Prajakta Sawan dari India. Yeah.
Well, so fascinating matchup. To a certain extent, we can consider Yugendran moving into the ranks of veteran, although he did appear this year in mixed doubles at the 2017 World Championships.
Bertanggungjawab sebagai seorang pemain, Ki Yugendran juga pernah menjadi
Ririn Amelia
lining
up with the illustrious Marcus Kido, also from Indonesia.
Ririn Amelia.
One of the things I really like about Marcus Kido is that he's just desperate to play the game. He just seems to be so keen to get on with it. And really modest Portugal kind of guy.
Memang mendominasi acara bergu laki bersama Hendra Setiawan.
Nice to see him gracing the court here today.
Antarabangsa dalam kejuaraan-kejuaraan BWF.
Memang
berpengalaman Marcus Kido.
The Petling Jaya really got no battle.
Main senior kini berusia 33 tahun.
Johor. She said she's just outside the top rankings of mixed doubles at the moment, but learning her craft.
And
what a great partner to have in the form of Yugendran, one of the most experienced players in Purple League.
She's
really been there and done it all, started out as a singles player in the national team, and
the transition to mixed.
And I guess having a bit of fun in mixed doubles as well.
It's almost like he'd taken up coaching full time, but now he's had a really successful 2017, as you say, into the World Championships and
the
finals in doubles as well.
Yang kita tahu memang sukar untuk mereka bertemu pemain-pemain dunia di pentas antarabangsa. Jadi dengan platform pembelik inilah peluang mereka untuk bertemu pemain-pemain yang berada di ranking yang terbaik.
9-6 the overall score to the team in black and red. It may well change after this, because they were well beaten 3-1 in their last appearance together.
Dalam edisi keempat. Selain daripada Ampang Jaya dan Petaling Jaya, sesi awal.
You know, lovely fellow though he is, he won't have any mercy once he gets out on the court.
BC menewaskan sedang BC.
Or am I reading that just a little bit too harshly on the girl from Johor?
Bagi Ampang Jaya,
well, we've said many times that it does often depend what the female player is able to bring to the table in mixed doubles. And the benefit of having an experienced partner at the front of the court cannot be overstated. So that's why I feel Ampang Jaya in a really strong position here. It's going to be a big ask for Ti to match Riri, who's active on the circuit playing mixed doubles
with
Johor. Achieving some good
successes. Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Ampang Jaya BC.
Lebih baik kerana
pengalaman. Petaling Jaya BC berbesar terbaik Ki Yugendran dan Ti Wei Chi. Petaling Jaya BC to serve Ti Wei Chi to Ririn Amelia level play.
Marcus
one
sets his trap.
Two
serve, two love.
Yugendran dan Wei Chi diturunkan pada semalam, namun tewas.
Sharp finish.
Three
tewas 3-15 pada semalam. Jadi tidak banyak waktu rehat untuk para pemain petaling Jaya BC.
Again, Bruno Blas gets PJ on the mark.
Sarasova, one, awal, three.
Mereka bermain kemarin, jadi pada hari semalam mereka berlatih dan ada yang rehat.
Audacious.
From Kido, just pops it into the corner.
Perlu dimantapkan lagi. Mungkin nanti tidak selalu
kesalahan. Sarasova,
three, four. Yeah, they're in the head too high.
Adalah peluang pertama untuk Marcus Kido. Dan yang kedua untuk Rini.
Jadi bagi Ririn juga berpengalaman, berpeluang untuk bermain dengan partner yang pernah menang medal dekat Sukan Olimpik. Nah, jelas sekali Kepelik ini membuka peluang kepada para pemain muda, bukan saja di peringkat tempatan di Malaysia tapi negara-negara serantau.
Wei Chi standing up to the onslaught.
Give her a lot of confidence.
Just pushes it wide, but she's certainly playing her part in the PJ team.
And I'm sure that Yogendra being there is a great help to her. He will just be saying, like, go out and do your best and don't think about the result. Just enjoy the chance to play against Marcus Kido.
Pengalaman dan skill itu memang ada. Cool dia orang dia dalam kandang.
A good lead. He had a second thought about Kido. Vivian did well at the net and Kido.
Pantang melihat pulang tinggi ataupun separuh gelanggang. Memang suka untuk pertahankan smashnya.
Gone out if Yogendran had been able to perform a remarkable feat of escapology.
Namun menariknya Roslin, anda sendiri bermain di peringkat antarabangsa, tapi kadangkala untuk para pemain muda ya ataupun baru melihat saja di bagian orang kata opposite jaring tu adalah pemain antarabangsa seperti Marquis yang pernah menang.
Push too long. Game point. Like 6 points in a row for Ampang Jaya.
Kadang-kadang benda tu agak sukar untuk kita mengelak dari rasa perasaan takut untuk bermain dengan pemain yang lebih baik ataupun lebih baik. Tapi itulah untuk kita.
Sarasova, five.
Bagi saya,
for the error, Marcus.
He's hunting down that shuttle. Saw the chance to close out the game.
Merasa keadaan sebegitu dengan cara mengutip banyak pengalaman sebenarnya dalam setiap pertandingan. Itulah sebenarnya yang boleh kita atasi apabila bertemu dengan pemain yang lebih tenang.
Yeah.
back of the court. You feel it is just delaying the inevitable.
Karena kalau main kenama pun kena main dengan baik kalau nak menang. Bukan free gift kan? Berturut-turut mata.
3 points in a row.
Ketinggalan. Mahu pun mencari-cari apakah strategi terbaik untuk mengutip mata dari Marquis dan juga Riri.
First game goes to Ampanja as expected. There was some resistance. But in the end, it's an 11-6 to 11-7 first game victory. And what can Wei Qi and Yugendran do to turn this one around? Because they very much as we expected that first game, Donald Spears.
Well, I feel they are strong on defense, so if they can. Somehow use that to their advantage. Marcus Kido at the back of the court is not penetrating on every attack. Speed. But I feel Rui is quite strong when she comes into the front of the court. So
20 seconds.
Can somehow
20
absorb
seconds.
Some of that pressure and use it on the counter attack. They may find they can profit from it.
Most of those red little dots, although they count as errors in this scenario, they were kind of forced errors. There were a couple of tame ones. For the most part, it was pressure shots causing the problems for PJ. Little face, Rira and Amelia.
Second game.
From in Padang on Sumatra.
Level.
Serving to Keyu Gendron.
Play.
Very much a KL boy. Whoa. There's a gift from Marcus.
Early
Christmas present, nicely wrapped.
So 1-0.
In the repeat, Rirun hit the net. Java, once from Sumatra. There was a gap the side of the Java Sea between the two there.
Tepat dari pasangan Lampang Jaya. Wei Qi mencari ruang kosong di bahagian tengah.
Sarasova,
2-0. Jelas dalam kategori bergu campuran, pemain lelaki perlu lebih aktif ya untuk melakukan serangan. Bulan smash dan para pemain wanita perlu steady terutama kerana mereka menjadi sasaran pihak lawan.
Rirun doing the work at the back. Talking about Donald, resulting in a point.
So sooner or later, all that attacking work from Kido is going to catch up with him. And craft of Yugendran sees the gap. So he's right on the left-hand side, Kido. Usually out of position and punished by Yugendran. Doesn't know a thing or two about badminton, this young fellow.
Suddenly PJ have a 4-2 lead. And this time it's not going to plan. good. Anya Gendron gives her the thumbs up. Don't stop playing the shots, I think, is the message.
She can spot the gaps nicely. Just couldn't execute the drop shot.
Forced error from the Ampang Jaya team. Three of them have come from Kido. Space for Kido.
And you see how well Riri protected the space at the back of the court there. This point here, you see Gilgendron trying to punish Kido again. It's Riri that's made the difference. I'm saying if somehow Petlin can keep her out of it, then
it's
going to go their way.
It's long from Gilgendron. Back to back points, five apiece. They're certainly working on a game plan, PJ. Pushed it long.
A bit of acrobatics from Gilgendron. I thought we were watching Gojak Chin for a second there, but great save from him.
It's making a little spin and turn to get back in position. Game here, it's
a bonus. Klub masing-masing kemungkinan tak berlatih sebanyak seperti masa aktif dahulu.
Yeah. Nicely played by Rurin.
Great defense from her, very solid. See the eyes flashing.
Mereka telah pun beraksi lebih kurang 12 minit. Masih di game yang kedua.
You see these little personal battles on the court develop. It's like a challenge to smash someone or deceive them. Or
oh, well played.
Just stretching forward, she's got one thing in mind, get the shuttle in the space. Jaya are leaving a lot of gaps on the court, it must be said.
Well, excellent defense from rear end, but eventually she just plopped it up. And an 8-6 PJ lead.
To be tea and know that she just flicks her Olympic champion. Gendron helped her out to win the point. Really positive stuff from Petlin Jaya here.
Back, awkward position just to try and bat.
I think that was the hardest hit of the evening from Marcus Kido. It sounded like it anyway. Look at this.
Tapi dengan ada pemain ternama, bukan saja pemain tempatan, tapi luar negara sedikit sebanyak memberi peluang kepada para peminat, sama ada yang datang di sini, spot Arena Sentosa ataupun menyaksikan secara langsung di Astro Arena.
Drink, but no court mic.
Belajar satu dua skill.
Tight second game.
Ataupun mewarnai.
Into the 15th minute of the game. Dropped over Gilgendron.
Kiskido ni memang bijak. Dapat melihat pergerakan pihak lawan di saat-saat terakhir. Menolak ke arah belakang. 8 sama di game yang kedua. Weichi pula.
Revenge is sweet.
It always happens, doesn't it?
Absolutely. And that's exactly what I'm talking about. Kido won't forget what he did, and you saw the personal battle developing.
Ririn slaps game point. Certainly moved into a different gear with the Indonesian pairing for Ampan Jaya.
And take the game. 11 points to 8,
and a 2-love lead.
Now that changed very quickly, Donald.
Yes.
I've got Dingy.
Again, Amelia very aggressive. She's, in a funny way, been the support to Marcus Kido, because she's not been afraid to move around the court and fill in where he is not. And also attacking from the back of the court, so I'm really impressed by Amelia tonight. As you would expect, she's on pretty much top form. She's number 33 in the world in mixed doubles game, so she is really proving her worth tonight.
20 seconds.
In many ways, she's been the dominant partner, which is strange to say with Kido. Certainly, more than played a part of the final point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 winners. So that's a match that's been won, or a game, sorry, that's been won rather than lost.
Mata atau winners point dan dua sebenarnya kesilapan dari
the Purple League 2017-2018 edition of the Purple League sponsored by Samsung and Senheng.
Match day 3.
PJ Foren taking on Ampan Jaya. Marcus Kido smashes across.
Yeah, that's his favourite shot because he's got a lot of winners in the previous games, and that exact angle of the cross-court smash from people in the backhand side.
And again, good.
So it's over. 1-0.
Too cute.
3-1. Cantik.
Sorry, partner.
Tulakan dari Marcus Kido.
He's still hungry for the shuttle, though, chasing it down until it falls out.
Into the body of Ririn Amelia.
3.
Ampan Jaya yang masih belum puas dalam sebarang perlawanan. Sudah pasti ingin mencari kemenangan ketiga berturut-turut. Ketinggalan kini 6-9 dari segi mata.
Well played, Ri. Jadi, Shmikenshugendron straight back. Quite right.
3-0 ini bermakna mata kenyamaan akan dapat kita lihat 9 sama, dan kita juga menunggu perlawanan terakhir antara Zufadi Zulkifli, Lee Chok Yun memastikan
mana.
There's a glimmer of hope here for Peddling Jaya.
We're in asking for justification of why the service error was called.
She's obviously come in with a serve which is perhaps legal in front of another judge, but the service judge has been quite particular tonight, so she will have to modify.
Three service faults all against her. And all square for all. Third against Kiddo, fourth against Kiddo. Just drops long. Ask the question. We'll look at the replay. There is no appeal. A little slump of the shoulders from Amelia.
She's taking out all that fury now, I can tell you. Well, we've seen Marcus Kiddo really come alive in this match. A little bit of a slow start from him, and now he's almost back to the Marcus Kiddo of old. Absolutely aggressive, dominating power play from him.
Six, the fight court wins.
Penling Giant players are really sticking up for themselves, because if there's one thing about Indonesian doubles players is they are some of the most aggressive in the world. I think they've really seen that with Riri and Marcus Kiddo trying to dominate, so this is a real trial by fire for T. You're getting to do a fine job.
9-6. Ooh, it's wide. It's wide.
So it's over. 7.
Jørgendrup thought
eight.
That was on the line. Long, it's three game points.
Four.
The underdogs, PJ. Too long, and PJ, credit to them, they've got a game plan, and it's been rewarded with an 11-8 third set.
Well, it's a crucial game because it keeps peddling ahead in the overall tie. The players before had been putting in a power of work to get their 3 points, so it would be up to the team manager to lead by example and just get something out of this match.
Sebenarnya banyak kesilapan yang mudah dilakukan oleh Marcus. Shikido, terutama di bahagian hadapan.
To say it was a fine performance from Petling Jaya in that game. That was some of the most aggressive badminton we've seen from Kido so far. But Petling Jaya withstood the onslaught. Find some attacking winners themselves. T has really been a standout player for me in this match so far. Guys, really rising to the challenge superbly well.
Unforced errors, total 11 from a team who lost them. 7 of the air 11 coming in that particular game. Well, so often we've seen before though, it is possible to come back from 2-0 down in this league. And Marcus Kiddo wants to really up the pace this time.
Mungkinan target mereka adalah untuk menang 3-0. Namun disitulah